During the last two big economic turndowns that I am familiar with, over the last 30 years, they have been very innovative and able to respond. So all the bistros da côté came in because of an economic turndown. When Robuchon saw and Savoie and the other people saw that their primary, very expensive restaurants were not filling, they had the good sense to buy a place across the street, next door, two doors down, and oftentimes from the same kitchen to begin with, but eventually in different kitchens, produce much less expensive food for people who were themselves under economic strain. The other great thing that came back, it actually is a return to the future, was the introduction of the menu, which was always preserved in the countryside, but not in Paris Central, where everything tended to be a la carte. Again, with the economic downturn, suddenly then the chefs and the owners and the investors responded. Now, I have a similar feeling this time around. Several restaurants already have sensed what's going on and have responded. The two that whose chefs I've talked to most are the guy who runs, or their two brothers-in-law who run the Clocher Perrier, and the chef at the Goumar, both of whom have said, in the first case, what we are going to be doing is providing the same level of food for the same amount of money and not raising our prices. So we will give value, but we have to continue to give value. Goumar, on the other hand, has said, we are reducing our prices, and I will use different products that are just as good, but maybe not as pricey. So already we've seen, and it's only what now, 3 months, 4 months into the real economic downturn, we have really seen chefs begin to change. What will happen in the next year is, I think, more of the same thing. In October, a person who has been watching the French scene for about 50 years and I were talking, and he said, have you noticed that the mid-range restaurants are empty now? I bet you that the palace restaurants are still full, and just walking there, we had seen the bar cafes on a square full, overflow indeed. I posited this in a column, and several chefs came back to me and said, it's not true, John. It's not just the mid-range. That there are places that are known, starred restaurants that are empty at night now, and that would have happened once a year. It's happening once a week. So it may be affecting many more establishments at many more levels than we really have anticipated. I have also read, and of course you see it every day on the metro and the streets, people eating baguettes with something in it. That's an unpleasant trend that's been going on for quite some time. And people don't understand food and they don't like food, they're going to just grab something on the run. I've seen the other side of this where especially Americans have wanted to take only an hour lunch and leave earlier in the evening so they would have a social life. And they have been looked at disapprovingly and they've been told, no, it is our tradition to go out for 2-3 hours and then we will work late. So I see both sides of this. The most dynamic and I think accurate food critic over the last 10 years is Sébastien de Mahon, who wrote for a very exciting publication, Zurbin, which had a very short life of 4 or 5 years only. And the magazine and his task, his goal were to stimulate people who were younger in the demographic between 22 and 35 to go out and eat, to experiment, to try new things. And his articles, I critiqued them because I felt they were too positive and they never found enough fault in some of the cooking. But it was clearly his goal to try and encourage people to get out because he saw this and was very worried that it was on a downhill slope.
That organization, Fooding, sort of falls into that category.
Fooding, Omnivore, Generation C, there's a great overlap in the people that run those three organizations. And De Meuron is one of the founders of them, too. But they very much are looking for outside ingredients, fusion-type food. People who are cooking, whether it's in Chicago or Tokyo or wherever. And that's, I think, a very good thing. If you look at Z Kitchen Gallery as an example, where Ladoy has people from all over the world coming through in, as stagiaires and is cooking very exciting food, constantly changing. He is open to outside influence. He is aware that things are going to change. And he's holding his prices down, and he's got, just gotten a star. So when you get a star, normally you increase your prices immediately. He has not done that. And I give him credit.
Is there any noticeable presence of this slow food movement in France?
That is a very good question. And the answer is no. And there have been articles on this because someone like Francois Simon, who has written a book on Tuscany and Tuscan food, and who loves Italian cooking, he and others have raised the question, why isn't there a slow food movement in France? Now, I think there's two things. I think it's like, Minnesota and Wisconsin, and there's always this tension between French and Italian cooking, and I don't think they want to be seen as imitated by doing what has happened in Italy. But I'm going down to Italy for just 10 days in a couple of months, or in 4 weeks, and I'm looking forward to the one guidebook I now buy is the Slow Food Guidebook, because I really trust it. I trust it, I think it's good, I love going to Gras, I love eating that food. I think it's something the French could learn from, and I wish they would. There are people in France who will say, we only use local product in season, when it's appropriate, and we use local suppliers, but they will not call it slow food. So there's a little snobism here, I think. To quote someone else who just gave an interview on the same subject this week, Podlaski, one of the most respected people whose books are now coming out in English, was asked, is French cuisine in real trouble? Everyone's saying it's in trouble. And he said, no, I think the quality of food, I think the excitement, I think the young chefs moving are exciting, and we should really get over this business of sort of morosité and everything's going downhill. And I tend to agree. I think people are inventive, imaginative, young, enthusiastic, and I think it's going to survive this economic downturn and other factors.
My own feeling is that we are headed into very, very difficult times indeed. I mean, even disastrous. And I have a feeling, my one faith is that in the gastronomic area, in thinking of France particularly, because that's what we're talking about, is that the people who are coming up now and are young and achieving eminence, if the whole economic system collapses, they are going to invent ways we haven't even thought of.
Indeed.
Of
indeed.
Somehow or other keeping it going.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.